It could have been an anti-war demonstration of the 60s, except the chants and the insignia revealed the protesters were graduates of another era. They protest nuclear power, which they say will eventually destroy this planet, if not banned. And in place of draft card burning come some bizarre symbols they identify with the radiation age. The songs, too, are familiar, though the lyrics have changed.
We say the nukes have got to go before it all comes crumbling down.
And into this Arizona protest came some of the land's natives. And though marching to a different beat, Navajos and Hopis won the support of their fellow anti-nukes. The masses are, for whatever reason, come others, seeking their support for one cause or another, or their money, in this case for anti-nuclear t-shirts.
This morning's demonstration was, to say the least, energetic. No laws were broken, but lawmen were here to make sure that that didn't happen, even though most of them didn't want to be identified.
Only one Phoenix officer was in uniform. Others huddled at the periphery of the protest, keeping an eye on all.
Can you tell me who you're shooting for? You shooting for the city police?
And apart from the main event, a small group was gathered for a rehearsal of sorts.
These are the people who will be going over the fence.
You're practicing?
Yes. They're going to be doing some role plays here of going over the fence. Some practice. And we're gathering our energies together here.
And anticipating the inevitable confrontation, plotted how to hop through the fence.
The outer lines will be people forming the circle. We're going to form a half circle. And it's going to be, the other half is going to be the barbed wire fence.
They're going to stop us within 3 to 10 feet. So we might as well use that fence as one of our barriers because we're not going to get very far past it.
Then propping up their imaginary barbed wire, they practice the imaginary trespassing.
There's supposed to be two real groups. People in ID, we're going to get back.
Which all went off without a hitch, this time.
When? All that depends on money and engineering and when Mars is close enough.
all pointing to around 1990. Randy Ripplinger, Cool News 10.